Okay, there's a lot of random wires just kind of like dangling everywhere on this thing. So I think we're gonna try and clean it up a little bit. Interior lights dimmer. I do have the knob for that somewhere. So we'll be able to mount that somewhere in the dash here. I do have the factory switch for the wipers, but the problem is this plug doesn't match that plug there, so we're gonna have to try our luck with it, I guess. See what happens with we're gonna pull each of these little clips out, try them in there first, turn the car on, see if it even works. If it works, then this can go somewhere in the dash as well. That cleans up something else. But I do need to go and get some tape because we got two red and blues on this one. Yeah, I've got to put a little bit of tape on one of these red and blues so I don't know which one was on the top for this plug. We're going to go with the row of three is going to be the top one. So I can loop you around, under, fold it in on itself. We can write a little tag on there. Alright, we're just going to try with the colour match first and remember which one was the top one. That one there. That one there. So blue and white was top. And then blue on the bottom. If this doesn't work, then we'll try matching these colours to the ones on the other side and see what happens.
How good? I have one speed. So it works, but I feel like I have to reverse the wires that are for the motor. No, for the water pump one.
This is really annoying actually, can I tap into these wires somehow? That way I'm not having to like stay under the dash the whole time. What have they done with these wires? The place that I took this car to get done, it sat there for months and months and it did nothing. And it was sitting outside as well. And I also found out that my rear light was leaking. So all the time it's been raining, there was water getting stuck in the boot. That's caused some problems. And they didn't even do all the jobs that I wanted them to do. I'm pretty sure I took in the factory switches as well, and they were just like, oh no, this one was already connected, so we just extended it. And I was like, that wasn't the job you were meant to do.
I'm trying to mix and match. Okay,
let's try our luck.
Hopefully good things. Okay, that's a start. I think it's trying to go faster. I don't know if it's trying to go faster. And then I think my...
not sure why it doesn't return. Hopefully. That's a good sign. That's not such a good sign. Why? I've finally got it. This chart doesn't match this switch, but for some reason this switch matches all the rest of the wiring in the car. So we now have, well, supposedly two speeds, it's the one speed. So the wiper moves, we put it up to the faster speed, and then we have spray, and they return as well, which is good. Okay, for this thing to fit, what I need to do, there's a little flathead, so we're gonna take that screw out, this knob pops off, and then we should be able to put it through that little gap that I got there. I have no idea if that's the factory location of it, but that's where it's gonna go.
Oh, this is certainly not comfortable.
I'm gonna drill out this one to get my interior lights dimmer in, and then that should be okay. Now the hand aerobics again to plug it in. God damn it. It works again. Something else has been successful. So we got the little light coming on there, and then I can dim it back down. All done by that switch. It cleans it up a bit more, but I think I want this over on the other side because this kind of looks a bit weird and crowded. That duck over there, so loud. Everything works. We're getting there. And they return. Geek. Horn works. Radio's on. Oh man. But for how little I know about wiring, we've had a pretty good day. The only thing electrical that needs to be sorted out is all my heaters and cooling and all that kind of stuff. But other than that, electrical, done. I've got to pull this off. Sand that back, flock that. We gotta sand this one back because I got this roll of like sticker bomb wrap that I think I want to put onto that. Then hopefully the next thing on the interior that we do after this video, new door cards, because I got some fresh door cards. I got some leather stuff to lay onto it, and we can put speakers into the doors rather than having them down in the foot jams, because down in the foot jams you can't hear shit. I gotta figure out what to do about this carpet. Up just like that. Okay. Should be able to disconnect you. I'm not sure if I still want to go around that front bit or not. I don't think this will bend the way I wanted to around there. Thank you. Okay. The moment of truth, if this all works or not. So we've got the adhesive. We got our bag here. A little sifter to shake it all over. I don't need that anymore. Don't need that anymore. Sick. We'll let that dry overnight, and then tomorrow we'll give it a quick little dust off. And I have new shift boot. Let's reassemble this dash all back together. I don't think I'm much of a fan of that spray glue either, because it didn't really do a great job of actually sticking all the fibers on there. Like, some parts it's done pretty good, other parts it's a bit trash. It seems like I've got some kind of like wire thing happening in there, but I'm not sure if maybe this will just work. There we go. That looks sick. I'm loving that. Okay, I think interior wise, we're almost done. I have no idea what I'm gonna do about the top here. I don't know. Yeah, I got no idea how I'm gonna make something with like the curves and stuff that this has. But next up, door cards. I've got door cards coming in soon. Got some fresh fabric to go onto it. And then give this whole thing a good clean, because it's so messy. I do have the little vent for the one on that side. And the funnel, pipe, I don't know. But my thing doesn't even work, so at some point that'll have to all come out again, so I can actually have some cooling and heating during the winter. If there's nothing that this cuts to after, then the next video is gonna be fresh door cards that'll really clean it up a lot.